Hello, everybody, and welcome to The Big Hit. My name is Peyton Trollinger. I'm joined alongside Alex Donaldson. This time, we don't have our headsets on because we have IUP Hockey joining us today. How are you guys doing?
Good. How are you?
Very good. Very good. We are honored to have them as our distinguished guests. And we're just going to ask them a quick, few questions just to kind of get to know them a little bit more. So,
actually, could we do real quick, because I know we'll need this in post. Could each of you say your names into the microphone? Just like go down the line. Just introduce yourself real quick.
Yes.
Hi, I'm Richard Wild.
Hi, I'm Jordan Adams.
Hi, I'm Zach Soy.
And I'm Hunter Fairman.
Awesome. There we go. So we're going to start off basic. Where are you guys from?
I'm from just outside of Pittsburgh.
Okay.
I'm from Erie, Pennsylvania.
I'm from New Common, Pennsylvania. It's like 10 minutes south of Harrisburg.
Okay. And I'm about 25 minutes south of Pittsburgh in the South Hills.
Okay, we got all PA. How'd you guys choose IUP?
I don't know. Actually, it was like pretty random. Like, I was getting recruited to play here, but then I wasn't going to go here, and I was like, coach kept texting and I would just not answer him, and I was like, I'm not going here. And then just one day I was like, all right, I'm going there. And then that's just how I ended up here. I don't know, it was just pretty random, actually.
Yeah, same thing. I was debating about going back to play another year of junior hockey or coming to IUP. Coach Hanzo was talking to me a lot, and got a lot of buddies on this team, so the recruiting process was pretty fun. They were talking to me, coach was talking to me. We got a pretty good team, so we're going to try and do it this year or next year.
I would agree.
See if we can get the job done.
Mm-hmm. All right, so I was originally going to go to Slippery Rock, but the team got suspended. So I was supposed to go with Jordan and Evan. Wow. And after I got suspended, I didn't know what I was going to do. And Jordan said he's transferring to IUP, and he told me to come there, so I followed him.
Yeah, so same story as his. I was originally going to Slip, and there was a haze or incident with their team, so Hanzo was on it right away.
And Coach Hanzo.
Coach Hanzo, oh yeah, you might want to bleep that out, actually. Yeah, Coach Hanzo reached out, and as soon as we came, I loved it here, so that's why I'm here.
Okay. Nice.
Okay. So did any of you guys, like, play against each other growing up, either before college or before IUP?
Yeah, I played against him.
Okay.
Yeah. Actually, growing up, I played with Connor Winsky and Kyle Ziemba. I've played with them since, like, 10 years old, actually. It's like, I never played against them unless it was high school hockey. Connor and I went to the same high school.
Okay.
So we would play against Kyle, but I played with him for 12 years now.
Yeah. Nice. All right. And then the question, I'll throw one of these in there. Who has the best and worst hair on the team, if you guys just want to go down the line?
Best hair, I'd say Dono. Worst hair, I don't know. Sights.
I'd say best hair, I give it to Connor Winsky, and worse, oh, man. I'm going to say Stahl. He's got the ball.
I knew it was coming. Yeah. I was waiting.
Yeah. Best hair, I don't know. I'd like to throw myself in there.
Okay. That's fair. That's fair.
Very fair.
But worse has to be Jared. Has to be.
Yeah, I'm going to go Jacob Fetzer. I think I like the long, curly hair that's coming out of the helmet, too. Kind of looks like Artemi Panarin. He used to have long hair. Now I'm going to go Jared as well. I think Jared Stahl is the worst one, too.
It's pretty bad.
Yeah, I was waiting for it because, like, I mean, he shaved his head, and then it's, like, starting to grow back, yeah, like, very slowly.
Love it.
What are... So in hockey, you know, it's very fast paced, you know, you're bumping around a lot. So what are some of the best PG-13 chirps or insults that each of you have heard or that you've said?
I don't know. I mean, there's a lot of chirps about the way they dress. You could just bust something off by that. Or like black laces like that kid we played the other night. He was it's pretty bad.
The mark, the red crown on the tape, that was absurd. I've never seen that before.
What? Really?
It was like shaded and oh it was, yeah, it's wild.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
PG 13, I mean,
There's not a lot. I figured.
Not to derail anything, but we can cut whatever we want, and obviously we won't air anything. So if you wanted to share something, we can bleep it out. That's fine. That's completely fair.
I mean, he runs his mouth the best. So.
You can say, like,
You should rattle him off.
Yeah.
I mean, a lot of it starts with, you know, like the F words coming out.
That's fair.
Usually, if like he said, the way someone dresses or the way they look, like the earpieces, you're wearing earpieces, you're going to get chirped.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Just not sty. Stall cages, ugly.
Oh, yeah.
Or
okay.
Like a white cage, unless it's like goes with your colors, you know, you're going to get chirped there.
That's really gross, yeah.
Yeah, and. Nah, yeah.
That's it.
I appreciate it.
So, one more serious note. How did you guys, each of you, fall in love with the sport of hockey? You know, when did you start? Who got you involved? And what's made you want to keep going?
Well, my parents got me involved. The earliest thing I remember is play like NHL and like PlayStation 1. It's like my mom and dad. Mm-hmm. That's how I got into it. I don't know. Ever since then, I've just loved it. Then, I mean, it's obviously a fun game, but like just being a part of the team and like being with all your teammates, I love it.
My mom got me into it. Her best friend's son, he was playing hockey, and he was a couple years older than I was. So, I don't know, I went to one of his practices and, like, watched him on the ice, and, like, I wanted to try it. But I remember my mom was telling me that when I first started, like, I started crying on the ice, like, I wanted to get off, but she paid too much money for the trial, and so I stayed out there. And if it wasn't for her, I probably still wouldn't be playing. So, I mean, earliest, probably, like, you know, being a part of a team atmosphere, just having, like, 20-plus friends automatically playing a sport that you love, you know? It's just a fun time.
I started randomly because my next-door neighbor brought up a hockey net just randomly one day, and I still missed that net back in the day and broke a few windows. And then he said, yeah, like, you should play ice hockey. And I was like five at the time. I was like, sure, yeah. And then I couldn't skate. I couldn't do anything for probably like 3 years. But then like I just kept getting better. And now it's, I mean, like, yeah, I love the game, but it's more of the boys, you know, like just the friends I've made, like you can't beat it. So that's what it is for me.
I started off playing at a young age. I think my cousin played before me, but no one really in my family played hockey. One day I had to stop playing baseball, and then I was like, can I try hockey? Picked up a hockey stick and haven't looked back since. So got to meet a lot of friends, a lot of lifelong friends along the way, and now I'm going to meet more for the next 4 years here. And have a fun time doing it. So that's how I started, and I've loved it since.
So this question's kind of excluding Fairman, I'm very sorry. But you know, you three were on the team last year when you guys won the CHMA title. So I want you to just take us through like that experience, because honestly it was last February. So just take us through that.
You know, the year before that, our freshman year, we lost against John Carroll in the semifinals, mm-hmm. and that was tough. And like we lost some guys, but like our class, no offense, I'm probably the best class. But I mean, we had a lot of guys, and so like returning, you know, we knew we had a shot. And then we were just rolling all year. In playoffs, we had a scare by Duquesne, mm-hmm. and how to win in overtime. But then, like going in the final, we just had that feeling. Like we had RMU all year. We even came back against them at their place. Mm-hmm. And, like, we just knew, like, we were going to get it done. And then getting it done was unreal. Like, I was a D-gen for a week. I can admit that. I was just celebrating. But, you know, it was an experience I won't forget, that's for sure.
That was an amazing time, honestly. yeah, that game against Duquesne was kind of was scary for sure.
Mm-hmm.
But if it wasn't for Dom Glavich, and you know, wouldn't have won that game without him. But yeah, the championship game, I played probably the best game I think I played all year, scoring two big goals, mm-hmm. kind of helping out and everything. But just the atmosphere in that rink, it was packed.
It was really packed.
And a lot of our friends and family were all there cheering us on, everything, and just the feeling afterwards, like all that hard work we put in mm-hmm. off season and throughout the whole year paid off in the long run.
Yeah, no, it's definitely hard, especially that game against Duquesne, but like they said, winning it was such a blast. I remember the locker room after it was one of the best times. It was so fun.
We were on there for a while.
Yeah, we were in there for a while.
So we talked about some past success. Now we're talking about, you guys are obviously on a winning streak right now. Do you guys have any superstitions like that you guys are keeping up over the past couple of games?
If you don't want to tell us, that's okay.
I feel like I've had it just since high school. I don't know. I put all my left equipment on before my right. Like if I'm putting my skates on, it's always the left side first. Okay. Just like little things. And yeah, nothing too crazy.
Yeah, I'm the same. I just get dressed the same way. I can't remember it off the top of my head. It's just like how it goes. And then I won't put my upper stuff on until 3 minutes before we go. Okay. 3 minutes before warm-ups start.
Okay.
That's just, I don't know why. It's just what I've done since I've been here. So.
Since I've been young, I've been trying to hop in the shower exactly a half hour before I have to be at the rink. So at like my house or my apartment, wherever I'm at. So mm-hmm. that's what I try to do. I try to set my alarm, and I gotta be in the shower at exactly a half hour before.
Okay.
It's gonna be a rough game.
That's interesting. Yeah.
Throws your whole rhythm off.
I don't really have any superstitions. I mean, I get dressed a different way every time. So, I don't know.
It's just always interesting to see what athletes say to that kind of question.
Jordan believes in his tape as a problem too with scoring.
Yeah.
The color of the tape is a problem.
If I'm not too. Like at the beginning of the season last year, I was like using black tape and I had like at least like what 13 assists, no goals, something like that. And I was getting really irritated, so I switched to white and started scoring. And same thing with this year. I had white, was not scoring, wasn't producing or anything, and I switched to black and I think I did pretty good.
Yeah, you've been doing good.
Obviously, you guys have four players. And we talked a little bit about statistics earlier, but the team has four players in the top 10 in points in the division. Do you guys like keep track of your own stats when you guys play, or do you just, is it like an afterthought?
Personally, I don't. I'm a defenseman, so I don't really
care
points to start with. So I don't really care personally. But every once in a while, I'll check them out. But I don't.
I mean, not during game, after game. Like just be like, oh, like I know how much I got. That's nothing.
Yeah, no, I don't really keep track of mine, but they're easy to keep track of. I don't get too many.
It's all right.
I know exactly how much I have. So.
Yeah, it's better to see that 3 points at the end of the game than to see 3 points for one person. It's a team sport, you know.
Exactly.
So that's a better 3 points there.
Mm-hmm.
So then on that, like kind of a follow-up to that, who do you guys think leads the team in penalty minutes?
Oh,
unless
gosh,
you guys don't know it off the top
Jace
of your head.
Jace Rearick.
Man, how did you know that so quickly?
I don't know. There's something in the air. I don't know what it was.
And then you guys know 2 and 3? They're both tied.
It's got to be SJ.
He has to be up there.
Or Blunden or Trent. Or one of the two.
Blake.
It's Blake and SJ.
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Unreal.
I'm surprised. I thought Fairman would be up there for sure.
He's probably not far behind them.
Yeah, it's 52 minutes, and then they both tie for 47 each.
Unreal.
Yeah. They're putting in the work.
That's actually kind of funny, though.
I know, when I was looking at the statistics for points, Trent, Jace, Maddox, and you are all in the top 10 in the CHMA in points. You have 20. 10 goals, 10 assists. So, I mean, that was kind of just like what he was saying, like, do you guys keep track of your stats? But another thing I wanted to bring up is that did you guys know you guys outscored your opponents 43-18 during this win streak? So I was just going to ask, like, what has been the key for success so far this season? You know, you guys are rolling hot. You know, some of these teams aren't easy teams to play against. You know, John Carroll gave you guys a scare. So, and you guys came out with the victory. So what's the mindset in the locker room? What's the attitude? How do you guys get it done?
I think just starts by showing up to practice at 7:30 in the morning on Tuesdays, and then we prepare that whole week, and everyone's excited. We have good practices. We're all feeling very good going into the weekend. We're all excited. If Marty scores, I'm loudest on the bench. If Soy scores, I'm the loudest. We're all just there for one another. We're finding, and it's part of hockey. When you start clicking, you start going. So yeah. We found something that if we can just take it all the way until Christmas break.
There you go.
I feel like, I don't know, I felt like there was a vibe beginning of the year that, like, everyone was more individual.
Mm-hmm.
And then, like, I felt like there was a switch. And then, like, everyone was like, all right, we got to do this together. And since then, I mean, like you said, we're outscoring guys and we're hot, we're on fire. And, I mean, I don't think there's anything that's going to change. But, I don't know, there was just a switch, I felt like. And then, boom, everyone just bought in. And then now we're rolling.
Yeah, I gotta agree. I think once we meshed a little bit better and the lines got switched around, that definitely helped out a lot. Mm-hmm. I think kids are playing up to their abilities and everything's starting to come together. So like they said, though, I mean, it's looking really, really good as of right now. We just gotta keep rolling.
Oh my God.
Stalzy. Hello.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I ran out of gas going to get it.
Oh,
oh my God. No.
Literally, my car's right there.
So, there's one. You guys, like, so you just touched on, you know, it's about showing up to practice, you know, making that commitment early. But how much, like, going into the weekend, everything's clicking. How much of each game is preparation versus, like, just adapting to how the game is?
I mean, you can prepare as much as you want. Like, you're still going to have to adapt, but preparation is a big thing. Being hydrated the night before, getting good sleep, showing up to the rink ready. And then, obviously, things don't go your way during the games. You have to adapt, so I think they're both a pretty big thing.
I think the preparation's the biggest part. Like we want to play the way we want to play. So preparing that way the whole week, coming to the game, we should just – play that way, you know? And then, obviously, you got to adapt if, you know, you get a bounce somewhere here or there, but preparation's so huge in it because, I mean, all week's work is just for the end of those two games, so you really got to prepare hard.
Yeah, I guess I'm just going off Zach here. Like, you never know what you're going to get on the weekend. You can prepare, but then you show up with no effort. If you show up with no effort, then it's going to be hard to win hockey games. And I think a lot of the adaptiveness comes with the coaches, too, when we're coaching on the bench and they're telling us switching up lines or switching up the power play unit or PKers. So, like I said, you can prepare all you want during the week. We can do power play and do good in practice, but if you ain't going to show up and work hard and be mentally disciplined, it's going to be hard to win hockey games.
Mm-hmm.
I agree with everything they said. Yeah. Like everything I was going to say.
And then what is – so this is, like, a controversial question. Everybody has their own, like, kind of – and there's a little bit of bias here. But what is the hardest sport to play and perform at a high level?
Hockey.
Fair.
I'd say boxing and hockey are one of – I'd say.
Okay.
Up there.
Yeah, I'd definitely say hockey and UFC.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm probably going to say hockey.
Fair.
And so don't worry, like, don't think about throwing each other under the bus or anything, but if it's hockey, what is the hardest position to execute?
I sort of want to say goalie.
I don't know.
Does it change if he's in the room or not?
No. I don't know. That's kind of hard.
I don't know.
I mean, they're all equally important, but
I'd say center, honestly. I feel like you have the most responsibility in both offense and defensive zone. But then I'd say goalie was, like, not as much. Like, I mean, I'm not saying goalie, obviously. I'd say they're pretty, like, neck and neck, in my opinion. Okay. I'd say center, though, for sure.
Sure, center.
Yeah, I mean, every position, you have to do different things. So all equally as hard. But yeah, center and goalie, I think, are the hardest.
All right. That's all I have.
That's so, yeah, honestly, yeah, all good. I have. Thanks, too. Guys. So we want to thank you guys for coming out. If this episode comes out before Friday, come out to S&T Bank Arena to see IUP take on Oswego State. It's going to be a fun one for sure. It'll be a little bit more competitive because they actually have a winning record. But I'm really excited. So, again, thank you guys for coming out. Yeah, we really appreciate you. No problem. Have a great day, everybody. Hello, everybody, and welcome back to The Big Hit. Again, my name is Peyton Trollinger. We're going to get a little bit active here in the studio. I got Hunter Fairman, Jordan Adams, and Richie Wild. And we're gonna just play a little bit of keepy ups. I know you're thinking this is soccer. There's our hockey guys, but it's a very valued tradition. Either in the NHL, doesn't matter what league it is, every hockey player plays keepy ups before the game. So, is there any reason why?
I guess tradition, and it's just a fun thing to get the boys' minds like away from the game for a little bit and have some fun with each other before you step on the ice.
Yeah, it's the same thing you said. It's get the boys loose and teamwork and everything.
Okay, you're good. Yeah, so we're just gonna start playing some keepy ups, and we're gonna try to talk while we play. I'm not very good at this, so it's gonna be interesting. All right, so like how do I start? Do I just bounce it?
Bounce it to whoever you want to.
All right. I'm getting jammed
over. You jammed me. Yeah, athletic, Marty. Right.
Yeah.
This isn't the most ideal. Oh, shoot. Yeah, this is not the most ideal space to do this. We're trying to be really careful right now. That was my fault. How was your day? How was your day today?
It wasn't bad, honestly. Yeah, I'm pretty productive today because of school.
I got to go to world geography, learn about Southwest Africa. It was fun.
Oh, there you go. At least you went to class.
I had class this morning, then I went to go skate. And then me trying to forward just playing.
Lost it's off camera.
academic
weapons. That's
we're,
what the hockey
is. Scholars here.
Yes.
Talk about y'all's like, best and worst hotel experience on a trip.
Oh man.
Oh boy.
I'd say the worst one. I forgot what hotel, but we were in Canisius.
Oh, that
two
one.
Years.
Oh,
I think it was like 2 years ago. I think it was my first year, and we got to the hotel and. I look at the bed sheets and it was gross.
They didn't change the bed sheets.
No, they did not change the bed sheets at all. So I think, and you can tell on the curtains, it just was like,
ew.
Yeah.
That's gross.
I went home though. Good thing my parents came to watch that game.
My freshman year, the one that told me to say that was, I don't even know what it was, but like, the people who like were working there, like they had a room in the back where they lived. It just worked real weird.
What?
Smelled terrible
too.
It was actually terrible.
We've been three hotel trips this year, and two out of the three hotels were me and Jason Gates having had a shower curtain.
Oh, that's
hilarious. Shower and the water's just on top.
Oh my god.
It was bad.
That's good.
played a little bit of soccer in my youth.
Yeah.
Wasn't very good, but.
Oh.
Where's the farthest that you guys traveled?
Like ever, like throughout college? Or
Like through the season.
We'll be Alabama.
Yeah, Bama will be the farthest. Yeah.
That's gonna be
Oklahoma was kind of, Oklahoma was also really far too.
Oklahoma.
Yeah, we went there. Was it last year? 2 years ago was my first year. First year playing.
Yeah. Oh, that was cool. Do I just kick it?
Yeah, you can only touch it two times.
Okay.
Yeah, just small talk.
Every practice?
Every
game?
Yeah, just about.
So, why do you guys do this particular thing before a game?
I think it's kind of just tradition from juniors, honestly. Like, everybody plays in junior hockey. And
that's a fault. Nice hat.
Yeah, I can understand that. We used to play football in cross country.
Really?
Yeah.
Some of the... Some of the Troy plays football.
Yeah, they'll throw the football around.
Yeah.
I'd say any of the Mighty Ducks movies, honestly.
All right, guys. Hope you enjoyed that little segment. Just meant to be fun, silly, just kind of improvised. But again, want to thank the IUP hockey team for coming out and letting us do this with them. Anything you guys want to say? No problem. Until next time, we'll see ya.